Next up, we have everybody's favorite downtown Oklahoma City writer and social media trendsetter, Steve Lackmire. Steve has been with the Oklahoman for many years. I didn't know how many, so I just said many.
25
years. And he is going to speak about social media and show us how to build up a Twitter following like nobody else. So please help me welcome Steve Lackmire.
I was blogging at the time. I was a columnist already. And quite honestly, I was uncertain where social media was going at that point. And there's only so many hours in the day. And trying to figure out, okay, is this something I need to spend my time on? And that's a question a lot of people are still asking. So there's a gentleman at the time who worked with me at the Oklahoman and in his own dastardly way. He created an account for me on Twitter. Sent me an anonymous email and said, you have 5 minutes to take ownership of this account and use it, or someone else will use it and you won't like what happens. That person is a bad, bad man. Well, the thing is, I've been using my blog. I had already created a blog that was a two-way conversation with my readers. And I had made fun of social media even. And how many of you ever watched Doctor Who? Okay, my son and I watch it all the time, and you got the Cybermen that are out to pretty much take over everybody. And so I put up a photo of Cybermen and basically equated getting on Twitter to being taken over by the Cybermen. So, I mean, I'm serious. I was not eager to get into it. So that thought was well known among my readers. And so as a result, my anti-Twitter approach to getting into Twitter got me 200 followers the first day. I cannot advise this as a strategy for you. But there was kind of a, how do I put it? I was almost very, I wasn't trying to like make a fool out of myself, but there was some self-depreciative humor involved with this. I wasn't taking myself so seriously on this that it was like, oh no, I'm too good for that. It was more of a joking kind of approach to it. And that's something that, it's a fine line. It's going to be different for each person. But when you're conversing with people, when you're on social media, my first big suggestion is don't take yourself so seriously that people are going to be turned off at the very start. Okay? And don't try to be something you're not. Okay? You've each got your own qualities, your own strengths, your own points of view. And if you try to fake it, if you try to act like you're above it all, social media, whether it's Facebook or Twitter, they'll find you out and it won't go well. So that's my first thing. And there was some very good advice given here in the last 15 minutes as to how to build up a following as far as finding out who's following who and all that. Listen to the conversations around you. Find out what circle you want to be in, if that makes sense. So I have, my specialty is covering urban core development in Oklahoma City. Now this is something I'm going to tell you is anecdotal. I don't have any numbers or surveys, and if I did, someone else would have something to contradict. I'm just telling you anecdotally, from my observation, Twitter is tending to be a younger, more urban crowd in Oklahoma City. Okay? And Facebook is tending to go the other way. And both are good crowds, and I'm involved with both. I have chosen to put much of my effort into Twitter because of what my specialty is. But that's not to say that Facebook isn't key to it all as well. But another concern that I have about really getting that much more into Facebook personally is it's getting to be a pay-to-play kind of situation there. You can build up a huge following on Facebook, and they'll bury your stuff if you don't pay Facebook to promote it. Whereas on Twitter, it's still very democratic. You got 10,500 followers, your message is going to go out to 10,500 followers. It's that simple. So that's another consideration to keep in mind. Now, both are very powerful mediums. Now, let's just look at what happened over the weekend. We had a very interesting coincidence go on where two things showed just how powerful social media can be. First one was a gentleman got sideswiped by a driver who then decided to drive away. But he got her photo right before she drove away. He tweeted it out. It got retweeted hundreds of times. Then someone found the photo of her on Facebook. He's now got a person he can report to the police on his hit and run accident. It's a different world, folks. You can't get away with what you used to. Everyone's got a phone. Now you've got another deal. There's a woman who went to a club in Bricktown Friday night. She went to several places apparently. And she lost an heirloom wedding ring worth $15,000 from her husband's grandfather or great-grandfather. So it's more than just $15,000 in value. It's got this, you know, heirloom value that you can't measure. And so they put out a picture of it, and everyone's thinking, man, she's screwed. Bricktown. A bartender found it at Club 115. And someone saw one of these retweets or one of the Facebook posts, and the woman's been reunited with her ring. One of the things that I do to connect with my audience is I'm known as the reporter that will retweet lost dog and lost cat photos in the urban area. You know, it's not going to be in Yukon or like Mustang, but the area where I know my readers are concentrated, I'll go ahead and do that. And a couple of times it's actually worked. I try to serve as part of the neighborhood, as part of the community. And there are others who do that too. It's not just about being a reporter or in media. There are people out there in various businesses who serve as part of the community. And that's where I'd advise you, even beyond, if you become part of the community, you'll get noticed. Just give it time, don't be pushy. If you do a Twitter account, Facebook account that says every day, hey, we've got XX widget on sale for $500, get in here now, we'll give it to you for $450. If you do that every day, people will drop you and no one wants to follow that. You've got to put some time and effort to being part of the conversation. That doesn't mean going on there and saying, okay, mayor's a crook, council's crooks, legislators are crooks, and I hate them all, and that's all you ever say. Okay? You can be critical, though, for sure. Get involved in the conversation. But my advice is be who you are. Be a mix. Show an interest in what's going on. Sometimes I've seen restaurants promote each other. I know that sounds like it's counterintuitive, but think about what Santa Claus did with Mr. Macy and Mr. Gimbel of Miracle on 34th Street. It's not a new concept, really. And that was part of the charm of that movie, wasn't it? We all want to just be part of the community, and sometimes we've all got different ways of doing things as merchants, as business owners, and it might not kill us to be friendly. And that's what social media is all about, is being friendly. You know, I've evolved on social media over the years. And I've tried out Pinterest. And I've got a Pinterest page still, but it's not active. I'm on LinkedIn. I'll be honest with you. From what I've seen, LinkedIn is good for you to have a network to start hitting if you lose your job. And that's fine. But I've not found any other real use for LinkedIn other than bragging about how many people you're hooked up to in LinkedIn. I've not figured it out. Foursquare was a big deal a while ago. It's kind of fading off. They redid it, and I don't know if that's going out that well. And that's the other thing I'll tell you is none of this is guaranteed to be around in 5 years. Facebook is, you know, continuing to evolve. They keep changing rules, keep on changing privacy settings, and so far people are sticking with them. But the numbers show the younger audience isn't. Younger audience is getting into things that, I'll be honest, I've not tried yet. Snapchat and, Instagram. I'm on Instagram. And even things that I'm sure I've not even heard of yet. It's continuing to evolve. MySpace was the granddaddy. Everyone thought that was going to rule forever. And it's never recovered from its early stumbles of going too intensive on advertising. So that's kind of what I've got to tell you this morning. I do believe that as we move forward, that there's always going to be a huge desire for our community to be informed. That's what I do. There's also a growing desire to be part of an experience, and building experiences is something you can do very well with social media. You look at the H&H food market that goes on every last third Friday or whatever of the month from spring to fall. They draw thousands now, thousands and thousands, like 20,000. And it was all built through social media. It's an amazing deal. They had coverage in the Oklahoma, they had some coverage in a couple other publications, and it just took off. And you can create that excitement, you can create that feeling of social media, of community and the experience through social media. And part of the key is just getting together with the right storytellers to help you tell that story.